Here we're asked to calculate the theoretical minimum work to cool liquid water from 20 degrees C to 0 degrees C, and we're given that our surroundings are 25 degrees C, and that's our only heat reservoir. And so essentially what we're saying is use a Carnot heat pump to remove the energy from the water to cool it down and transfer it to the high temperature, in this case 25 degrees C. That would be in a minimum work, a reversible Carnot cycle. Of course, it's not realistic in particular because as the water temperature changes, then the low temperature of the Carnot cycle must also change to keep it reversible, and that's not practical. But let's look at a drawing of what the process is, and at least this gives us a boundary of what's the minimum work to do this cooling. So here's our process. We're going to cool water down, transfer the heat using a heat pump. So to keep reversible, the low temperature of the heat pump is continuously changing. The high temperature is at 25 degrees C. And we're going to use the first law and the second law. The first law is just adding up energy. So let me write that here. QC plus QH plus W equals zero. That's the first law. And let's also be careful with the signs. QC is positive. We're adding energy to the heat pump, and our system is the heat pump. So we're doing the balance here around the heat pump. QH is negative. We're removing heat from the high temperature reservoir of the heat pump. And W is positive. We're doing work on the heat pump. So the second law then says that delta S is going to be zero for the pump. This is because we're assuming we can carry this out reversibly and having a temperature TC change. If we now look at the behavior, I'm going to say delta S has two terms. And I'll write it integral because TC changes. So in general, the QH over TH, this is zero. So we have to be careful with signs here. DQC is CP dTC over TC with the integral sign. And so we can say we're lowering the temperature of the water from 20 degrees C, which is 293 Kelvin, down to 0 degrees C, 273 Kelvin. But remember, we're making a balance on the heat pump. And so this is the opposite sign. We're removing energy from the reservoir, and so this term for entropy change is going to be positive for the heat pump. So the minus sign is so that we're getting the behavior correct because we are defining QC relative to the heat pump. TH is constant, so we can just integrate DH because TH is constant. This is equal to zero. And so what we can do is integrate this. So minus the heat capacity times the log of TC evaluated between our limits plus QH over TH is equal to zero. And so now we can substitute in values and rearrange this. So QH is going to be TH times heat capacity of water, the log 273 over 293. Now we can substitute in the values here. So I've evaluated the log term. I used the heat capacity for water in joules per gram per Kelvin. And so I can calculate QH, and it's minus 88.1 joules per gram. So it's negative, as we said it should be. And this then allows us to calculate the overall QC at just minus CP times delta T. CP delta T is the change in the energy of the water. We have the opposite sign for the energy being transferred to the heat pump. So this is, again, the heat capacity for water. And then the temperature, final temperature, is 273. Initial temperature, 293 Kelvin. And so QC, minus sign here, this is negative 83.6 joules per gram. Now I can go back to the first law. Again, this number is greater than zero, as we said it would be for system being the heat pump. So 83.6 QH is minus 88.1. These are joules per gram, plus W equals zero. So W equals 4.5 joules per gram. That's positive. That's the minimum work. And that's what we're trying to calculate for cooling water down. Of course, a real system is going to take significantly more than this.